Hello friends, today we will understand the concept of consignment accounting under that normal loss and abnormal loss. First we'll take up the concept of normal loss. What is this normal loss? Normal loss is a loss which is unavoidable by the consignor or the consignee. Both the parties, they cannot avoid this loss. So here what will happen while sending the material on the nature, it depends upon the nature of material. While sending the material, it may be while loading or unloading, while cutting the bulk material or sending some petrochemicals. So that by the nature of material, some material will be lost, and that loss which is unavoidable is called as normal loss. Then the question arises, what is the accounting treatment of this normal loss? Generally, the normal loss will not be calculated separately in consignment accounting. Instead, while calculation of value of closing stock, we will apportion the loss of normal loss on good products. So here what we will do? We will calculate while evaluating the closing stock, the normal loss will be absorbed on the material of good products, right? So there is no specific accounting treatment. So we will work out one problem based on this. We'll understand how to calculate the value of closing stock under when there is a normal loss. Here we have a small question where the question says that 100 tons of coal are consigned at 300 per ton. So the cost of each ton is 300. Freight and insurance paid by consigner amounted to rupees 2000. The non-recurring expenses of the consigner. Loss due to loading and unloading of coal estimated 5 tons. It is estimated already by the consigner that the 5 tons will be lost while loading and unloading the material. So it is a normal loss. So out of 100, the normally lost is 5. Hence, the consignee will receive 95 tons. Whereas 76 tons coal is sold at 400 per ton. Ascertain the value of unsold stock. Here we need to calculate the value of unsold stock. Then how to calculate the value of unsold stock under normal loss, when there is a concept of normal loss? It is a simple. So we need to calculation of value of closing stock. So always the consignor wants to recover the loss of normal loss from the good units. So when he is sending 100 units, 100 tons, of which 500 tons are lost. So the consignee is receiving only 95 tons. Whereas the consignee sold 76 tons. In the sense, the balance of material lies with the consignee is 19 tons, right? So how we got 19 tons? Total are 100 minus 5 is equals to 95 minus 76 sold is equals to 19 tons. So we have got only 19 tons of material. So how to calculate the value of closing stock? How to calculate the value of closing stock here? Here what we will do? So each ton cost is 300 rupees. We have incurred, so we apportion the cost of normal loss on good products. So here we will take the value of stock. How to calculate the value of stock here is 300 per ton into we sent 100 tons, which has become the cost of only 95 tons, into leftover are 19 tons.
Right.
So what we have done? So the total cost of sending the material is 300 into 100, that is equals to 30,000, which has become the cost for 95 tons. So we have incurred the 30,000 expenditure for sending 95 tons, of which we are left with only 19 tons. When you calculate this, so 30,000 divided by 95 into 19. So we are getting the cost is 6,000. So this is the value of material is still left with the consignee. Now, proportionate expenditure. Expenditure of consignor. So while sending the material, consignor incurred the expenditure of 2000 rupees. So this expenditure of 2000 into 19 divided by 95. So total 2000 rupees expenditure incurred for sending 95 tons, of which 19 tons are left. So if you calculate this, 2000 divided by 95 into 19 will get 400 rupees. So total value of closing stock is 6,400. Again, the similar treatment we will do. We don't do any specific treatment for abnormal loss, normal loss, right? Only it will be used while calculating the closing stock. Now, I hope you understand how to deal with this normal, but the question arises, what is the accounting treatment of abnormal loss? That we need to understand, right? So abnormal loss is a normal loss which can be avoided provided we should have taken some precautions, right? Next concept is abnormal loss. How to do and how to do the, how to treat and how to do the accounting treatment. So here, right. So the abnormal loss is unavoidable loss. What is the accounting treatment? So the abnormal loss will be credited to consignment account while recording in consignment account. So the general entry will be abnormal loss account data. The entry will be abnormal loss account data. To consignment account. In the sense what? This abnormal loss will be credited in consignment account, right? When the claim is lodged with the insurance company and the insurance company admitted the claim, then insurance company insurance claim account data to abnormal loss. But so far here we require this entry, that is abnormal loss account data to consignment account. Clear? Then we specifically value the cost of abnormal loss. How to calculate the cost of abnormal loss, which is similar to the calculation of closing stock, what we have discussed in our earlier videos, right? So how to calculate the value of abnormal loss? Same, cost of material lost plus proportionate expenditure of consignor. The summation would be the value of ABL. ABL stands for abnormal loss. So what we are taking? Cost of the material which we lost and proportionate expenditure of the consignor. Comes together, we will calculate the value of abnormal loss and it will be recorded on the credit side of the consignment account. Clear? So we'll try to work out a problem based on the abnormal loss, with the help of which we will understand how to do the problems based on the abnormal loss concept. Here, Prakash of Hyderabad consign to Vijayawada 50 cases of goods at a cost of 5,000 per case. Prakash is the consigner. Prakash of Hyderabad is the consigner, and Vijay of Vijayawada is the consignee. 50 cases each costing 5,000 per case. Prakash incurred the following expenses: freight 4,500 and insurance 12,500. Vijay paid cartage 2,000 and rent of rupees 2,280. Four cases were destroyed in transit and a sum of rupees 15,000 agreed by the insurance company. So out of how many cases were sent? 50, of which 4 were lost. In the sense, consignee has received only 46 cases. That is 50 minus 4. Out of 46 cases, 36 were sold for rupees 6,000 each. Vijay is entitled for a commission of 5% on sales and sent a bank draft for full settlement of account. Show the consignment account and Vijay account in the books of Prakash. So we are asked to prepare consignment account and consignee accounts. Anyhow, goods sent on consignment account is a small one we can prepare. So the basic crux of the question is, how many units? 50 cases were sent. 50 cases at the rate of 5,000. Per case each, of which 4 cases lost, and consignee receives only 46 cases. Now we need to prepare consignment account, consignee account, and goods sent on consignment account. So we will prepare the ledger accounts and try to understand the concept. Right. So first of all, I will prepare consignment account. Then consignee account. So always bear in mind, we must prepare all the accounts simultaneously. All the accounts simultaneously, then only we can work out the problem very fast and with good accuracy. So simultaneous preparation of ledger accounts is always recommended, right? So this is consignment account, and consignee, who is consignee here? Vijay account, that is consignee, and this account is goods sent on consignment account. Right. So basically, you are aware already, general interest we have discussed in our earlier videos. So we need to work out the problem based on the general interest. Right. So directly, if you remember the general interest, we can directly prepare the ledger account without any hesitation. Right. So first, how much of value of material has been sent? So 50 cases each costing 500. So what is the entry when the material is sent by the consignor to consignee? The entry would be consignment account data to goods sent on consignment. In consignment account, we write to goods sent on consignment. I have written abbreviation because of paucity of place, but whereas you need to write complete in the examination, you must not use abbreviations in the examination, right? So 50 cases each costing 5,000. So 5 so it amounts to 2,50,000 is the value of material is sent. Next, the consignment, then it will be recorded in goods sent and consignment account by consignment account, 2,50,000. All right. Next, consigner incurred the expenditure. How much expenditure the consigner has incurred? So 50 cases. Prakash incurred the following expenses: freight 4,500 and insurance 2,500. Consolidatedly 17,000 expenditure. So what is the entry for expenditure? The consignment account data to bank. 17,000 is the expenditure incurred by the consignor. Consolidatedly 4,500 plus 12,500. The summation we have written. Next, Vijay paid, that is consignee paid cottage 2,000 and rent 2,280. So Vijay expenditure. Whenever the consignee incurs the expenditure, what is the entry? Consignment account data R to consignee to Vijay. So expenditure comes to 2,000 plus 2,280. So consolidatedly it is 4,280, right? And it will be recorded in Vijay account by consignment 4,280. Next. So 4 cases were discharged in transit. A sum of 15,000 was agreed upon by the insurance company. We will calculate separately the value of abnormal loss. Out of 46 cases, 36 was sold for 6,000. So sales. Whenever material sold by the consignee, what should be the entry? So the entry would be consignee account data to consignment. How many units we have sold? So we sold 40 out of 46 cases, 36 was sold at 6,000. 36 into 6,000 comes to 2,16,000. So in consignment account, we write by Vijay 2,16,000. How we got this value? That is 36 cases into 2,16,000, 6,000 each case. So we will get 2,16,000. And in Vijay account, we write to consignment 2,16,000. Right. Once this entry is done, next is what? Vijay is entitled for a commission of 5% on sales. On this 5%. So Vijay is getting 10,800 as the commission. So what is the entry? Consignment account data to Vijay. To Vijay. That is 2,16,000 into 5%. That is equals to 10,800. And in consignee account by consignment, 10,800 is the commission. So both the sides we have recorded. Once this recording is done, and next is what? Right. The balance is settled by a draft. Now the most important calculation comes to two calculations. One is calculation of valuation of closing stock or calculation of closing stock and calculation of abnormal. So first we'll value the valuation of our calculation of closing stock. Cost of material left with the consignee. Our closing stock, you can say closing stock. So out of 50 cases, 4 were lost and 46 were received, of which 36 were sold. And the leftover cases were 10 cases, each costing 5,000. So it will be 50,000. Then proportionate expenditure. First we will take proportionate expenditure of consignor, proportionate expenditure of which consignor. So consignor incurred the expenditure of 17,000. So we'll take 17,000 into how many cases were left? 10 divided by total cases are 50. So 17,000 into 10 divided by 50. So we are getting 3,400. Right? Then consignee expenditure. So here, as you are already aware, while taking consignee expenditure, we will calculate, we will take only recurring expenditure. Sorry, non-recurring expenditure. Recurring expenditure will not be considered, right? So here Vijay incurred an expenditure 2,000 towards the cottage and rent is 2,000. So rent is a recurring expenditure. We don't take rent. We take only cottage 2,000 rupees as a non-recurring expenses of consignee. So we'll take 2,000 into how many cases were left? 40. Out of the consignee received 40. So here 46 will be the denominator, right? So why we are taking denominator 46? Because consignee has received only 46 cases, right? 54 were already lost, right? So we'll take denominator 46, whereas here we have taken denominator 50 in the sense consignor incurred this expenditure for sending 50 cases. The 54 cases were lost in transportation. So here we'll take denominator 46. So this comes to how much? 2000 divided by 46 into 10 cases. That comes to 435. Now we'll make the summation. So this summation, 50,000 plus 3,400 plus 435. That is equals to 53,835. So 53,835 will be the value of closing stock. So closing stock will be recorded on the credit side by consignment stock. So 53,835 has been recorded. Now calculation of value of abnormal loss, ABL. How to calculate the value of abnormal loss? Calculation of value of abnormal loss is quite similar to the calculation of value of closing stock. Just we need to understand how much of the material has been lost. So cost of material. So 4 cases were lost, each case costing is 5,000. So 4 5s are 20,000. Then proportionate expenditure of consignor. So consignor expenditure is, as you are already aware, total is 17,000. So we lost 4 cases out of 50 cases. So 17,000 into 4 divided by 50. So this equals to 1,360. And we don't take consignee expenditure because consignee not at all received the material. So consignee expenditure will not be considered for calculation of value of abnormal loss. So that is equals to 21,360 is the value of abnormal loss. Right. So what will be the accounting treatment? Just now we understood the entry that abnormal loss entry is abnormal loss accounted are to consignment account. In consignment account, we write by abnormal loss, right? So by ABL, as I told you, abbreviation should not be used in examination. Here I'm writing because of I need to put a cap on timing also, right? So total, how much we have calculated? 21,360. Once this is done, next thing is closing of consignment account and ascertaining the profit. So close the consignment account and find out the profit. So when you close the consignment account, so here it will be the summation is 2,91,195, and the balancing figure profit to P&L account. So how much we are getting profit here? To P&L account, we are getting profit 9,115. So this is our profit, 9,115. Here I have to highlight, we have circled. So this is the balancing figure. You should not circle in examination, right? So to identify, to show the balancing figure, I have circled it to make you clear. So now this profit we have got consignment, then close the consignee account. 2,16,000 is both the sides. And the balancing figure by bank, as it is stated in the question, it will be settled by bank. So the amount will be, their amount remitted will be 2,920,000 will get the balancing figure. So this amount will be remitted by the consignee to consigner, right? Balancing figure. As per the statement of the question, if it is not remitted, then we'll write by balance carried down to balance brought down, it will be continued. Then we will close the goods sent on consignment account. This consignment account, it will be transferred to trading account or purchases account, any account. So 2,50,000 total. So it will get tally 2,50,000. So like this, you need to work out the problem based on the information we have provided. The most important is calculation of value of abnormal loss. Don't worry about the abnormal loss. Abnormal loss is quite easy. As we calculate the value of closing stock, in the same way, we need to calculate the value of abnormal loss. At the same time, what will be the accounting treatment? It will be recorded on the credit side of the consignment account. I hope I made you understand this concept, right? So we'll see one more question. I'll show you the important calculation. You can easily work out this question, right? So just we'll understand one more question of abnormal loss. Hero Cycle Company consigned 100 cycles to Ram of Hyderabad. The cost of each cycle was 300 rupees. Consigner paid 10,000 for freight and 1,500 for insurance. During the transit, 100 cycles were totally damaged. The insurance company admitted the claim at 28,000. Ram took the delivery of 900 cycles and paid 1,530 for octroi, and sales received from Ram shows that the account sales received from Ram shows that the following: sales 800 cycles, 425. In the sense, what we sent 1,000 bicycles, of which 100 were lost. Consignee received 900, of which consignee sold 800 at 425. So still unsold stock is 100 and abnormal loss is 100. Expense of the consignee 2000. So nothing has mentioned. It is a recurring expense. Commission is 5%. Ram settled the account by bank draft. Prepare the consignment account and Ram account. So it is quite easy. You can prepare. So very fast will calculate, will proceed with the calculations, right? So without taking much time, I'll draw the accounts. I should have done it first so that we would have consumed less time. No problem. Still we'll do fast. This is consignee account. And finally, last one, the small one, goods sent on consignment account. All right. So this is consignment account. Who is consignee here in this question? The consignee is Ram of Hyderabad. So Ram is the consignee, Ram account, and goods sent on consignment account, right? So very fast we'll post the transactions, right? So here, Hero Cycle consigned 100 bicycles, sorry, consigned 1000 cycles to Ram, each is 30,000. So two goods sent on consignment, 1000 bicycles, each is 300. So 1000 into 300 is equals to 3 lakh rupees is the value of material. Next, consignee paid 10,000 for freight and 1500 for insurance. Consigner, sorry, in the goods sent on consignment account, we write by consignment account, that is 3 lakhs. Right? Next. To bank, the consignor expenditure, the summation is 10,000 plus 1,500. Consolidatedly, it is 11,500 is the expenditure of consignor. Next, 100 bicycles were destroyed, right? Ram took delivery, 900 bicycles was, right? And he paid 1530 for octroi. Right, Ram's expenditure to Ram, 1530 he paid octroi plus 2000 expenditure, so 2000 consolidatedly he incurred expenditure 3530 rupees. 1 plus 2 3530. So in consignor Ram account, by consignment, that is 3530 the expenditure. Then consignee sold how many units, how many bicycles? 800 bicycles. So by Ram, see, this ledger posting entirely is done based on the what we call journal entries. So once you remember, once you buy heart the journal entries, quite easy for you to deliver. So by Ram, how many bicycles is selling? 800 bicycles, each at the rate of 425. So we need to calculate, that is 800 into 425. So the sales would be 3,40,000. So if you calculate this, 3,40,000. So in consignee account to consignment, 3,40,000. Right? And commission is 5% to Ram. Commission, that is 3,40,000 into 5%, into 5%, that is 17,000 is the commission. So by consignment, 17,000 is the commission of the consignee, right? So directly I am doing the ledger posting, you are understanding here. Once everything done, we need to come to the calculation part. So calculation of value of closing stock and valuation of abnormal loss. Right, just try to understand how I am working out here. Concentrate and you can easily understand. So calculation of value of closing stock. Cost of material left with the consignee is 100 bicycles, right? How we have arrived at 100? He sent 1000, of which 100 lost, reached 900, sold 800. So leftover is 100. 100 each costing 300. That is equals to 30,000. Right? Next. Proportionate. Expenditure. Under which Consignor incurred the expenditure for sending the material is 11,500. Into how many bicycles we are left with? 100 out of total 1,000. So if you calculate this, it would be 11,500 divided by 1,000 into 100. That is equals to 1,150. Then consignee. Consignee expenditure is only 1,530 we take. Why we take 1,530? Because 1,530 is only the non-recurring expenditure. Rest of the 2,000 is recurring expenditure. So divided by 100 into 100 divided by 900, bear in mind. Why 900 denominator? Here we took 1,000 because this expenditure was incurred for sending 1,000, whereas consignee took the delivery of only 900 bicycles. Hence, we take the denominator 900. Right? This is the most important thing you need to bear in mind. If you take 1,000, it will be wrong. So 1,530 into 100 divided by 900. That comes to 170. So this is the value of closing stock. So closing stock is 31,320. So where it will be recorded on the credit side? By consignment stock or closing stock. 31,320. Next is valuation of closings, abnormal loss. So valuation of ABL, abnormal loss. Cost of material, the same 100 bicycles were destroyed, 300 each, that is 30,000. Then net expenditure of consignor expenditure is 11,500 into 100 divided by 1,000. So 1,150. And bear in mind, consignee expenditure we don't take while valuation of abnormal loss, because consignee is received only 900. So consignee is not at all incurred any expenditure towards the abnormal material. Hence, we don't take. 31,150 is the value of ABL, abnormal loss. What we do with ABL? ABL will be credited in consignment account by ABL, abnormal loss. That is 31,150. Then we will close the accounts and find out the, I'll quickly calculate the amounts. 3 lakhs plus 11,500 plus 3,530 plus 17,000. That comes to 3,32,032. Right? So we'll calculate 3,40,000 plus 31,320 plus 31,150. So 4,02,470. 4,02,470 minus that expenditure, is it? Our profit is 70,440. 70,440 to PNL account. Right now, close the consignee account, you'll get the amount remitted by the consignee. So I am closing the consignee account. That is 3,40,000 both the sides. Okay, so 3,40,000 minus, right, minus 3,530 minus 17,000 the expenditure. So 3,40,000, that is by bank, remitted by the bank draft balancing figure. That is 3,19,470. So in the same way, we need to close the goods sent on consignment account even, right? So it should be 2 trading account. So it comes to 3 lakhs same. Then close this and this account will get checked. Right? So in this way, we need to work out the concept of abnormal loss. There is no difficulty. Only the difficulty is calculation of abnormal loss. Abnormal calculation is quite similar to the calculation of closing stock. Right? I hope I made you understand. Please do subscribe my channel for more videos, and your subscriptions will give me motivation whereby I can utilize my knowledge to share with you people. So do subscribe my channel and motivate me and encourage me to make more videos. Thank you very much.